The UN does a study every year about the happiest countries in the world. Guess which is the happiest country in the world? Finland. Canada, sorry. Canada's 15. Thank God, the States is 16. Wouldn't it be sad if they were happier than us? It would be. Scott, put up the next slide there. Those are the happiest countries in the world. Okay, anybody from Finland here? Finnish background? No? Danish? Anybody happy here? Those are the top 10, and it's interesting, isn't it? What's interesting to me is a couple of things. Those top 10, most of the countries are not hot countries, right? They're cold, wintry, snowy countries. So what you think might bring happiness doesn't necessarily bring happiness. Another thing that I noticed is that many of these countries are socialistic countries. Socialized Medicare, medicine, a strong unemployment system and social welfare system. So despite what some people might say that socialism is communist and it's a bad thing, it is not. I believe personally it's in everybody's best interest if all of us are looking after one another, right? That makes sense to me. What else do you notice about five of the top 10 countries there? You won't get the connection. You know what it is? Five of the top 10 countries are Lutheran. All right? See, you didn't know that. All right? Did you know Finland was Lutheran, Denmark, Iceland, the top three, and Sweden and Norway? Those are strong Lutheran countries. Germany, about a third of Germany, they were 14, one ahead of Canada. This is the number one reason I believe those countries are. Why not, right? And I say that tongue in cheek, but maybe not so. Maybe it's the strong Lutheran tradition in some of these countries that led them to be a socialized country. And the message of the gospel was so profound in these people's lives. And in my opinion, that's what it is, the gospel. The gospel calls you to look after your neighbor, to put your neighbor before yourself. That is the message. And maybe a strong tradition of hundreds of years of this message led them to this point. But when you think about it, I have to believe that if we were Lutheran, you are Lutheran, but if you were Lutheran, you should be happy, right? Not because you're Lutheran, but because of what it is we profess and what we believe in. And we don't all believe the same, but the teachings of the Lutheran Church will bring happiness, in my opinion. The gospel is the power in our lives. It's not the law. It's not the list of all the do's and don'ts. It's not the power. The hell and the devil are not the power in our lives. It's God, God's love for us. It's the gospel that is the power in our lives. And if we live the life that we're called to in the gospel, we will be happy. As I read the article, what's really important is gratitude. I preached about this a couple of weeks ago. Being grateful for what we have is of the utmost importance. What's one of the most important spiritual things in our lives? And yet our human nature reminds you every day and nearly every moment about the things you don't have. God calls you to a life of gratitude, to rejoice and give thanks for all that you do have. And in Canada, we have a lot. Benevolence appears on the criteria also. Being benevolent. And that's part of our Christian journey, right? To be benevolent. For what we have, God asks us to share with others. And your human nature will tell you, you know what, take it easy on that benevolence thing. You don't have it. You have to make sure you have enough. You're saving for a second or a third place or a luxury car or this. Make sure you have enough before you start giving to other people. Human nature will tell you that, you know what, the poor people, there's a reason they're poor and it's their fault. In the United States, there's a huge movement that says people who don't have medical care, it's because they're too lazy and they don't have jobs and they don't work. That's not the reason. We have to get past this. Benevolence is reaching into our hearts and sharing all the blessings that God has given to us with other people. The last 2 years, we've been doing lots of ordering out. We don't go to many restaurants. Occasionally we do. But I have chosen benevolence as a part of that journey. And even though somebody's just handing you the food, I'll give them a 20% tip. A, I can afford it. B, they probably need it. And it's a sign of being benevolent, right? All of these refugees that are existing in the world, okay, the Ukraine, there's probably 1.5 to 2 million refugees. We're probably going to start bringing them over here. That's a small portion of the tens of millions of refugees around the world. We are benevolent. The Lutheran churches in this community of Regina have gotten together to have this refugee support committee. And we're continually bringing more people over here. We could probably even do more than what it is we are doing. Forgiveness. Letting go of anger. Letting go of revenge. These are all a parts of our Lutheran faith and our Christian journey. We do not become happier by being angry people, remembering negative things that people have said or done to us. And as we get through COVID, all of us have to practice forgiveness. Everybody has seen things a little bit differently in their own eyes and their own understanding. We need to forgive one another, live together in community, and move forward. That's our call. So aren't you happier today knowing that you are Lutheran? You should be. No. And if you are Finnish, God bless you. That's awesome. Amen. Let's rise to sing the hymn Day by Day.